groups.
Yesterday, the Guardian for Children and Young People, Shona Reid, released two submissions to the government's discussion paper on alternative diversion models for raising the age of criminal responsibility in South Australia. The first submission, titled From Those Who Know, is on behalf of young people who have been detained or denied their liberty at the Adelaide Youth Training Centre, compiled in her role as the South Australian Training Centre visitor. The second is a more formal submission on the Guardian's own behalf. The Guardian for Children and Young People's submission highlights concerns with the government's proposed alternative diversion model. In particular, these relate to the increases in police powers. And I refer specifically to page 21, where the Guardian states, "I am seriously concerned that the places of safety network may not prevent arrest of children, but instead act as an authority for a form of pseudo-arrest. If this occurs, it is unlikely to reduce children's admission to police facilities or the time spent in police cells." The submission that the Guardian has made on behalf of detained young people contains first-hand accounts of their experiences in the judicial system. Young people in particular talk about their challenges understanding the terminology used when they're arrested and finding their interactions with police difficult. One young person states, "I just remember crying and I told the police everything and then I became a snitch because I didn't know what was right. I didn't know if I was meant to say or what I wasn't. Yeah, it was embarrassing. It was really scary as well. Like, imagine two police officers coming in and saying, 'Oh, yep, you're getting arrested for this.' And at that point in time, I didn't actually think I'd done anything wrong in terms of my behaviour." My question to the Attorney General, therefore, is, has the Attorney General read the submissions from the Guardian for Children and Young People? And what assurances would he provide to that young person quoted in the report in relation to the government's proposed alternative diversion model?
Call the Attorney General.
I think the Honourable Member for his question, as the Honourable Member has correctly stated, there was a discussion paper released in relation to the topic of the minimum age of criminal responsibility. There are a number of other jurisdictions around Australia who have started processes in relation to this. I think the ACT, Victoria and the Northern Territory are all at various stages. And I think all of them are proposing to raise the age to 12, certainly at least initially. And I note that in the submissions the Honourable Member refers to, that is a topic of criticism if that was being proposed here. The discussion paper set out one possible model, and I'll preface I'll include in my comments that we don't have a formal view as the government as to what, if anything, will change in relation to the minimum age of criminal responsibility. But the discussion paper was a start to look at what various models might be in place if it wasn't a strictly criminal justice model. Consultation has closed. There are some dozens and dozens of submissions. I've read a summary of all of the submissions that have been made. I'm now working my way through what will amount to many hundreds of pages of submissions made by a whole range of stakeholders who have views on this. And then the government will decide what action it takes.
Supplementary question, Mr. Sims.
Will the government commit to releasing these submissions publicly so that members of parliament and the community can consider the stakeholder feedback?
Attorney.
Yeah, I think the Honourable Member for his question, I'm certainly happy to consider this. I'm trying to remember amongst the many, many submissions if there may have been some that were asked to remain confidential, particularly if they're ones that talk about people who have lived experience, particularly in the youth criminal justice system. There will be very good reasons to remain confidential, but I'm happy to have a look at to see what we can do in relation to that.